Good morning, students. Yesterday, we have completed three stanzas of this poem, that is the school boy, isn't? And today, I'm going to start from here. Okay? So, this is the poem, The School Boy, which is written by the William Blake. In this poem, the poet is conveying his own ideas and thoughts through this boy. He has compared the childhood days sometimes with this like a bird, sometimes with these birds, isn't? So now let's go through the stanzas. First of all, I'm going to read for you. How can the bird that is born for joy sit in a cage and sing? How can a child when fears annoy but droop his tender wing and forget his youthful spring? O father and mother, if birds are nipped and blossoms blown away, and if the tender plants are stripped of their joy in the springing day by sorrow and care's dismay, how shall the summer arise in joy, or the summer fruits appear? Or how shall we gather what griefs destroy, or bless the mellowing ear when the blast of winter appear? So now let's see one by one stanza that what the poet is trying to convey the message. So now let's read. How can the bird that is born for joy sit in a cage and sing? In this stanza, the poet has compared the children with this bird. Okay, he says that if the bird, how could a bird that is born for a joy, means that has born to live freely, isn't, to live freely and enjoy his life, how could it sing inside the cage? How could it sing, how could it stay and live happily inside this cage? Because inside the cage, it's bound to be there, isn't, and it has to do only the things what it has been said by his master. So in the same manner, how can a child when fears annoy, so in the same manner, how can a child, how could be the children, those who fears, those who are having a fear from the, here annoy means that is angry and the irritate. So how under such a condition, how under the irritated condition, angry situation, how the child can grow but droop his tender wing? And under this situation, what happens? The children, they are going to lose their tender wings. Tender means what? Tender means that is soft, and droop means that is bend. Okay, so under this condition, the children are going to lose their tender wings, means their natural beauty, their natural way of growth, according to the poet, and forget his youthful spring. And under such circumstances, the children are going to forget their youthful spring. Here, youthful spring word has been used for the days of childhood. Okay, because if their days are full of with anxiety, worries and the fear, then how their childhood days, how these children are going to be bloom in the future? Now, let's see. O father and mother, if birds are nipped and blossoms blown away. Now in this stanza, the poet has compared these children with these birds. Flowers are appeared from what? Flowers are appeared from these birds only, isn't? So if their birds are going to be proper, then only they are going to blossom the flowers, now. So what the poet is saying, that he is just conveying through this boy that, O father and mother, means here this boy is complaining to his parents, to his father and mother, that if birds are nipped, if birds are nipped means if the birds are going to be bitten or pinched sharply. So obviously if there are no birds, there could not be any flowers. So as I told you that here in this poem, this birds has been compared with the children. So if these birds are nipped, listen, if these birds are bitten or pinched sharply, cut, then blossoms blown away, then their blossom to blow in the future, it will be blown away. And if the tender plants are stripped, and if these tender plants are stripped, stripped means remove all covering, to remove all coverings from, and from, if from this tender plant, from this soft plant, if the coverings are going to be removed, what type of coverings? Coverings of just like a joy, happiness, of their joy in the springing day, by sorrow and cares, dismay. So how this tender plants, from these tender plants, how all the coverings are removed? These coverings are removed in the form of the sorrows and the cares, isn't? So if the children are going to be under this situation, then how they are going to be joyous in the childhood days? I mean, how they are going to bloom in the future? Here the springing days, it's for the youthful days. How shall the summer arise in joy, or the summer fruits appear? Or how shall we gather what griefs destroy, or bless the mellowing year when the blast of winter appear? Here in this stanza, the poet says that when the time will come, when these school days are going to be converted into these winter days. Why the poet has compared these school days with the winter? Because winter, that is full of, that is cold, chill, isn't? And the summer, that is full of warm, warmth is there, so much warmth is there, just like a fire, isn't? So how shall the summer arise in joy? What the poet is saying, he says that how shall the summer arise in joy, when the time will come, when these summer days are going to be turned into joy, means when the time will come, when these school days are going to be turned into a joy, or the summer fruits appear. And when the time is going to come, when the summer fruits are going to be appear. Or how shall we gather what griefs destroy, or bless the mellowing year when the blast of winter appear? So he says that when the time will come, when the school days are going to be the chilled one, or the full of enjoyment, or when they are going to bear the summer fruits, when they are going to be the interesting one. So or that year should be blessed. Here mellowing means that is a relaxing year. So when that relaxing year is going to be come. Okay, so this was all about this poem, that is the schoolboy. So this is all about this poem. So what you have to do, you have to go through these lines, okay, and in your copy, first of all, you have to write down this, that is about the author William Blake, okay, along with this picture. If you can manage to paste it, you can paste, and if you can't, then you have to draw this, okay, in your reader copy, this picture and this thing. In your book, it is given in some like a creamish color. This thing you have to write in your copy. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you and have a good day.